My congrats goes to Sean Porter for winning a dominant unanimous decision versus the game undefeated 22-0 formula. Sean Porter pretty much portered him. The formula to beating Sean Porter is you have to have more talent than him in order to stand a chance. See, the thing about Porter, he's good all around the board. He has a great chin. He could fight in the inside. He could fight in the outside. He could fight mid-range. And what makes Sean Porter an outstanding fighter is that he could be a bull and a matador. Plus, he's very awkward. So, the formula of beating Porter is that you have to at least have more talent than him to even have a chance at upsetting Sean Porter. Therefore, even though Formula was 22-0, an undefeated fighter on the come up, his chances at being Porter was pretty much slim to none. However, let Paulie tell it, the best fighters in the game today are Europeans. But the better question is, where? Because every time I'm watching TV, and I'm not talking about Aki TV, every time I'm watching a fight, the United States fighters always dominate. And more importantly, the fighters on the coincidental list. However, making ridiculous statements like that is the reason why Paulie doesn't have a job today. Therefore, let's get straight to the business at hand. Sean Porter looked tremendous tonight. He pretty much did whatever he wanted to do in the ring. Sean Porter made his presence felt, and he broke Formula down. However, Formula was a very, very gamed opponent, which he did not give up, regardless of how much he was outclassed by Sean Porter. So he definitely earned my respect. Sean Porter, on the other hand, I believe he could have got the knockout if he went bull mode all night with a relentless pressure, but it seemed like Sean Porter was trying out different things. He wanted to try different elements from his toolbox, which that's exactly what he did. However, that prevented him from stopping the game opponent, Formula, who was undefeated. Therefore, the notion of Sean Porter fighting like a football player, according to AB, is pretty much played out because Sean showed his skill tonight against a very, very game opponent. However, I thought it was very telling. The commentators were pointing out the fact that Sean Porter need to apply relentless pressure if he want to get the stoppage, which they were 1,000% correct. However, when Sean Porter did back up after landing great punches on Formula, either to catch a breather or try different things, working on different elements from his toolbox, they were pointing out the fact that Formula wasn't letting his hands go as much as he should have. But what they did not realize is that Sean Porter was looking to counter Formula when he was on the back foot. That's why Formula was not letting his hands go, especially after he took a beating. So he was trying to get his head together because every time he let his hands go, he will also get countered. So regardless if Sean Porter was on the back foot or the front foot, Sean Porter was always active, working on different things. Now, that's not to suggest that Sean Porter looked perfect tonight, because he did make silly mistakes here and there, getting careless, which he ended up taking flush shots because he was in the line of fire since he was just too comfortable in the ring against Formula. However, if you box, you're gonna get hit, just like if you swim, you're gonna get wet. Unless your name is Floyd or Shakur. Nevertheless, the million-dollar question is, who should Sean Porter fight next? And who is available for Sean Porter to fight next? Obviously, he wants the winner of Errol Spence versus Danny Garcia, but he already fought both of them guys. Sean Porter has the deepest resume in the welterweight division and one of the deepest resumes in the sport of boxing. Therefore, since Errol Spence and Danny Garcia are too busy fighting each other, that's not really an option right now. So, a better pick is a Keith Thurman rematch, since Keith Thurman is looking for a big mega fight next. They had a classic war the first time, so why not run it back? However, the best pick will be Sean Porter versus Terrence Crawford if they could some way, somehow make that fight happen. Now, Terrence Crawford, he could either pick or choose between Keith Thurman or Sean Porter. Now, if I'm being honest, Terrence Crawford versus Keith Thurman, for example, will be a bigger fight than a Sean Porter versus a Crawford. It will also be more pleasing on the eye. It will be a prettier fight than a Crawford versus a Sean Porter. However, stylistically, I truly believe Sean's style will trouble Crawford way more than Keith. If Terrence Crawford could dominate a guy like Sean Porter, that would be a hell of a statement. Now, we do know Keith Thurman is coming off a loss, and Sean Porter was coming off a loss. But if we being up to date, now Sean Porter is coming off a win. So what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you is a lot of bad boys at the welterweight division. This is our golden era. As long the best fight the best. So hopefully Terrence Crawford is gonna mix it up with the PBC fighters before an Errol Spence clash, because that's gonna build the fight even more. With that being stated, which fight would you guys prefer? Crawford versus Sean Porter or Crawford versus Keith Thurman? And which one is a tougher fight? With that being stated, subscribe below if you're trying to get smarter by the minute. If you're trying to get dumb about a second, don't listen to these decafs, the dumb casual ass fans / old media that don't know shit about boxing. Word to Roger Mayweather, may he rest in peace. And if you're a casual fan and you want to be a hardcore, all you have to do is click on the notification bell to get notified every time I post or go live on Split Decision. It's a boxing debate / talk show, mixed, master engineered, produced by yours truly, Aki, the past, present, and future undisputed pound for pound when it comes to debating. So call in, tune in. These decafs always treat Aki like the Iron Mike of debating, the most feared. I done ran out of decafs on Split Decision. I can't pay a decaf to call in because they don't want to get exposed by the truth. So with that being stated, I also have another boxing show, which is a talk show on Wednesday with my own Aki. It's called Boxing Hood. This is the Brotherhood of Boxing. Aki stand for my brother. So I appreciate every single one of my Akis. If you want to be an Aki of mine, all you got to do is subscribe and click on the notification bell. And to be continued on the next episode of Aki TV. Peace, and we out of here.